Hello everyone and welcome to a series of videos on multi-period accounting in Financial Accounting Hub. So broadly we are going to cover followings in this series of videos. A brief about what is multi-period accounting. It's a non-concept, so we'll just briefly explain that. What is that multi-period accounting? And since Financial Accounting Hub is used to integrate with a custom applications, non-Oracle applications. So if any multi-period accounting kind of transaction is happening in legacy system, then we do not have already built-in journal lines in Financial Accounting Hub or seeded journal lines to map that multi-period accounting transaction of the legacy. So we have to configure that. So to achieve the multi-period accounting features for that particular transactions. So how to configure Financial Accounting Hub to meet the requirement of multi-period accounting? So that's another thing we will go through. So main focus of this video is to explain how to configure Financial Accounting Hub to perform the multi-period accounting. So before we go into application, let me give a business example so that we should be knowing what are we trying to do in application. So as we know that the multi-period accounting basically for the transactions which has its accounting as spread across multiple periods, it not only in one period. A very good example to explain would be in your organization, if they pay rent for their building to any corporation for in advance. So for an example, an organization pays rent to someone for the period of this, means starting from 1st of December 19 till 31st March 20. For this period, they are occupying their space and for that they are paying a rent of 4,000. So they are paying the rent on 1st of December. That's advance payment. But as per the accrual basis of accounting, we are not supposed to book the 4,000 as expense to our book because the expense is not done yet. As and when we complete the rental period, the expense will be done and then only we should be booking the respective expense amount to our book. When we talk about the accounting, this will be clear. So this is the business scenario. That we pay rent in advance of 4,000 and the rental agreement is for the period this one. How to handle this, how the accounting of this will happen, should happen as per the accounting rules. So the moment we create we have to pay the rental invoice, first we have to create invoice for 4,000 and in that case we are going to debit the prepaid rent account. It is not an expense account, rather it's an asset account. So prepaid account will be debited by 4,000 and liability account will be created by 4,000. And as and when we pay the amount, the liability will be knocked off. So I'm not going to discuss that flow, the payment flow. My more interest is how to settle this particular asset account. So this is what we paid and the account we are paying on 1st of December. So the asset is booked on 1st of December 19. On 31st of December, since we use the space for 1 month, so we should be booking the respective rent expense account for 31 days, the number of days we have used the space. And so we should book the amount, expense amount, as per, there are two basically conventions. One is prorate based on the periods, and second, prorate based on the number of days. So we are going to discuss the prorate based on the number of days. Prorate based on the number of period is a bit simpler. We are going to take the case of prorate based on the number of days in the period. And how the amount is to be calculated, it is something like this. So the whole period of the rental is 1st December to 31st March, 1st December 19 to 31st March 20. That means we are paying the rent for 122 days. So rental paid for one day is 4,000 divided by 122, which comes to this figure. In the month of December, since there are 31 days, so The expense what we should be booking is 31 into the rent for one day. That is 32.7869. So finally, we should be booking the expense for 1016 in the month of December. So when we created the invoice, accounting entry was this on 1st of December 19. After that, we should not be doing anything. That's what that is what expected from the system. System should automatically recognize the expense on 31st of December for the respective amount. So this should be the accounting entry on 31st December of 19. Rent expense. Here, this account is an expense account, and we are booking the expense on 31st of December for 31 days. Again, on 31st of January 20, the respective amount should be booked. This is the amount by same formula. On February 29, the amount will be booked according to the number of days the rental space is utilized. So this is how, and if we see at the end, this will become 4,000. If we total all these amount, this will become 4,000. So by 31st March of 20, we will be debiting the rent expense account by 4,000 and crediting the prepaid rent account by 4,000. And this entry will happen across the period, across the multiple period. And that is why we call it multi-period accounting, MPA. Probably that's why we call it like that. So this is what the business scenario. So what are we, this is what the accounting expectation. Now assume that, now what is the expectation from financial accounting hub? The expectation here that in legacy system, there will be only one transaction where it will say that I am paying an amount of 4,000 as a rental. Rental period is from this to this, and that is it. After that, all the accounting should happen on the respective dates automatically. So let's see how we can do this. So we will show the respective configurations, what I have to do in Financial Accounting Hub for multi-period accounting feature. So first thing is that our data file should contain two dates, and those dates are the starting period of the contract and a starting date of the contract and end date of the contract, and that should be mapped to two predefined accounting attribute, that is multi-period start date and multi-period end date. So these are two predefined accounting attribute for financial accounting hub. So multi-period accounting start date is mapped to date 1 in my data file. Multi-period end date is mapped to date 2 of my data file. So in data file, there will be two additional fields, date 1 and date 2. And those fields are respectively mapped here to the accounting attributes related to multi-period accounting. So this is one setup what we have to do. Now, when we before I explain the next configuration, let me just clarify one more thing here. So if we directly see here what are the different journal lines we should have. So this is prepaid rent account journal. So let us call it accrual journal line type. This is liability journal line type. This is the recognition journal line type, because this is the journal line where we are actually recognizing the expense. And this one is same as this prepaid rent account is same as the this prepaid rent account. So again, this one is accrual. So distinctively, we have three different journal line type which need to be created for the multi-period accounting feature. Okay, so that is it for this video. Further configuration I will explain in the next video. Thanks a lot for watching. Please follow my next video on the multi-period accounting and financial accounting hub. Thank you.